This week on Cracked Science, it's cute when kids play doctor, not so much when grown men do it because a spirit told them to. Hey, this is Jonathan Jerry, and you're watching Cracked Science, a show from the McGill Office for Science and Society that separates sense from nonsense on the scientific stage. There's a man out there who claims a spirit from the future talks to him and allows him to properly diagnose and treat people's ills. And I can tell that pretty much all of you watching right now are fighting the reflex to roll your eyes, but perhaps for different reasons. Some of you predict I'm about to mock someone in whose powers you believe, while others simply can't imagine that anyone would be credulous enough to believe in this premise: spirit from the future gifts ordinary men with ability to play doctor. After all, it does sound like the premise of a USA Network TV show that did well enough in season one to warrant renewal, but got canceled after 2 years, and an unfortunate cameo by Ed Sheeran. And yes, we are releasing the full poster on social media. The man is called Anthony William Coviello, better known as the Medical Medium. And his following is massive. He's a number one New York Times bestselling author with 4 books to his name. His Facebook page has 3.3 million followers, and he's received endorsements from major celebrities like Robert De Niro, Rashida Jones, and former Dawson of Dawson's Creek James Vanderbeek, forcing me to revive this meme for the rest of eternity. Why, Dawson? Why? And if you browse through Amazon's listings for his books, you will be inundated with positive reviews, such as this one: if you want to take your power back from doctors and from the drugs that are destroying your body, if you really want to understand what is no longer working for you, if you are tired of being tired, then maybe you owe it to yourself to read this book. It might help you begin to live a more healthier, happier life. I was wondering why his books were getting so many positive reviews, given their underlying premise that a spiritual being whispers medical information from the future into a guy's ear, until I remember the results of a Gallup poll conducted in 2016. It turns out that 72% of polled Americans say they believe in angels. And that's the crux of it, really. If you believe in compassionate supernatural beings that watch over us, then there's really no leap to believing that one of them, called Spirit, tells a guy called Anthony that Mrs. Espinosa has lung cancer, even though her doctors can't see it. Also, there's a $3,000 grand prize package that was offered by the Medical Medium's book publisher to the most inspirational book review, a contest that was unearthed by Ray Paoletta at Inverse. The winner would get 2 phone consultations, which were highly prized as they retailed for about $500 each, as well as tickets to a live event and autographed copies of the book. So, there was that too. If I were desperate for a cure, fed up with the medical establishment, and believed in angels, I would be incentivized to write that I can't imagine living with the gift that God has presented Anthony to use in this lifetime, as it must be unbearable day to day, but his soul must be of an advanced nature to have made this agreement, and for that I am truly grateful. Namaste. And this genuinely makes me sad. There is, unfortunately, an indolent system that allows predators to take advantage of people with these beliefs, with little to no consequences. Because to my mind, and I say this as someone who is not a medical authority or a lawyer, what Anthony Williams seems to be doing is practicing medicine without a license. He used to offer phone consultations, but mysteriously stopped doing it between July and December 2016. But on his weekly radio show, he has a call-in segment in which people share their symptoms. And here's how this conversation went.
Kind of started, just being honest, having trouble with incontinence a little bit.
I'm doing a scan to see what's happening with the incontinence, so that's one thing. I want to make sure everything's good. And you've been to the doctor with that?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
That's not from muscles. It's a pudendum nerve, and that is inflamed. There's a message being sent to the bladder. It's inflamed in there too, and you're getting incontinence because of it. I would do the celery juice. You know, I talk about the celery juice.
Yeah. Okay.
16 ounces every day. You do that for like 6 months. So Spirit says if you get the right kind of B12 in you, plus you're doing like the celery juice, which is anti-inflammatory to the bladder, and you do these things, you're going to be in a better place.
Anthony Williams' business is based in Sarasota, Florida, according to the Better Business Bureau. And the definition of the practice of medicine, according to the Florida legislature, is found in, wait for it, Title 32, Chapter 458, Article 305. Practice of medicine means the diagnosis, treatment, operation, or prescription for any human disease, pain, injury, deformity, or other physical or mental condition. But it's okay for Anthony to do this legally because he has a disclaimer. And it's so long, it gets its own page on his website. And it clearly states that even though, for all intents and purposes, it looks like Anthony's practicing medicine without a license, he really isn't, and you should know better. This is known as the Quack Miranda Warning. And this statement seemingly is enough for many authorities to turn the other way, especially because their hands are already full with complaints involving actual doctors. On top of this, as Jan Bellamy of Science-Based Medicine pointed out, certain states in the U.S. have actually set up a separate healthcare professional category called the Unlicensed Practice of Healthcare. And other states, like California and Arizona, provide some legal cover for unlicensed practitioners by actually protecting them from being prosecuted for the practice of medicine. But if, after all this, you still believe in Anthony William, the guy who tried to trademark the phrases medical medium and spirit of the Most High, but failed to respond promptly to the registration service, let me save you the time to call into his radio show and expose Anthony's most common MO. He will tell you you have Epstein-Barr virus.
What you do have, though, Spirit tells me, is a viral issue, and it's Epstein-Barr. It's because you have a classic chronic case of Epstein-Barr that's going unnoticed.
He'll tell you to eat every 2 hours.
You need to eat every couple of hours.
He'll spin the wheel and tell you to avoid whatever food comes up on it.
Are you doing the no wheat? Are you doing the no dairy?
And finally, he'll tell you to try the right kind of B12 and celery juice because they cure everything.
So there's a B12 that Spirit has, you know, brought to my attention years ago that I've been waiting forever to come to the surface, because you can go to your best clinic, your best, you know, naturopathic clinic, your best conventional clinic, and they won't have this kind of B12. And it's called adenosylcobalamin. Celery. Why do I push everybody to do celery? Because Spirit does. I'm sick of celery. And Spirit says, this person needs celery. I'm like, again? And Spirit said, yeah, because this person needs celery.
And there's no way for him to be wrong. If he gets it right, boom, proof that his spiritual guide is all-knowing. If the caller disagrees, well, the caller's wrong, or their doctor is wrong, because Spirit has to be right. None of this is ever falsifiable. Except, of course, when he says everything is all right, and it really isn't.
Anthony, let me ask you, so Christina volunteered for a reading. Would you be willing to do that for her?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, you don't have a disease, so to speak, you know, when people worry and they're like, oh my God, do I have a disease? What's happening? I don't see any of that. I've looked, I've asked Spirit, that's not there.
That this diagnosis came in 3 days ago. It had nothing to do with anything that happened. It just happened. It's like winning the lottery. I have what's called multiple myeloma. It's not a fatal disease. It is a blood disease.
Oops. I guess the spirit from the future didn't see the cancer in her blood supply. And Ms. Ferrara is not the only one who's been misled by Anthony William and his imaginary friend. Paoletta's piece for Inverse, which I mentioned earlier, gives voice to Kate Gallagher-Leong, who was told by the praying medium, see what I did there, that her son Gavin, who had hearing and respiratory issues, was infected by, you guessed it, the Epstein-Barr virus, that Kate herself had given her son the virus. The treatment Anthony recommended? Vitamins. Her son died 48 days later, and it was the mom who felt guilty because she thought she was the source of her son's illness. And while Gwyneth Paltrow herself can't get angry over this and lets Anthony write articles for her Goop website, the last person you would think of actually has higher standards. As a psychic myself, I am ashamed of this narcissist charlatan man. So if you are American and would like to file a complaint against the medical medium, if, let's say, the spirit moves you to complain about the fact that you think he's practicing medicine without a license, here is the complaint form, link in the description below on YouTube. As for me, I give up. Practicing medicine without a license is clearly where the money is, so you know what? I'm gonna give it a shot.
What troubles you?
Well, I've had this cold for the past like 15 minutes.
Epstein-Barr?
Okay. Well, sorry, what?
Epstein-Barr? You're infected with the Epstein-Barr virus.
Wow, how'd you know that?
There's an angel called Carrot who speaks to me and tells me things.
Okay, I'm a bit skeptical of that. Do you have any proof?
You just have to have faith. Carrot is from the future, and he whispers advanced medical information straight into my brain. That's how this works.
Okay, because I've also had digestive issues.
Epstein-Barr virus.
Epstein-Barr virus?
Carrot says it's Epstein-Barr virus.
Headaches?
Epstein-Barr.
Insomnia?
Epstein-Barr.
Right, I'm also really tired. Could that be Epstein?
That's a virus from the shingles family, actually. Yeah, didn't see that coming, huh? Carrot is from the future, he knows.
So if the answer is always Epstein-Barr virus...
Or a virus from the shingles family, not shingles. It's never shingles. Shingle-ish.
Right. So why should I give you money then? I mean, the main recommended treatment is rest, so...
Have you heard of celery juice?
My recommendation this week is Ray Pauletta's in-depth article about the medical medium for inverse. Highly, highly recommended. Check it out. If you haven't subscribed to our YouTube channel, do click that button and ring that bell to get notifications. Don't forget to subscribe to our weekly newsletter by going to mcgill.ca/OSS. In the meantime, you can follow me on Twitter @CrackedScience and join us next time for science that may or may not be all it's cracked up to be.